Hello children, welcome to chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss the methods of removal of permanent hardness. The method of removal of permanent hardness. So our topic is removal of permanent hardness. First we will know what is permanent hardness, what causes permanent hardness, why permanent hardness is present in water. So what causes permanent hardness? So we have already discussed the hardness of water, and the hardness of water is due to presence of calcium and magnesium salt. But when calcium and magnesium salts are present in form of chloride and sulfate, it causes permanent hardness. So what permanent hardness is due to presence of calcium and magnesium soluble salts in form of chloride and sulfate. So what causes permanent hardness? If calcium and magnesium salts in form of chloride and sulfate present in water causes permanent hardness. So you know that permanent hardness is not a good quality of water. So you can say permanent hardness we have to remove. Why? Because due to permanent hardness, this water has permanent hardness, can't be used for cleaning the cloth. For cleaning action and for water is not fit for drink. So we have to remove the permanent hardness. So there are some methods by that we remove permanent hardness. There are following methods by that we can remove permanent hardness. How we can remove permanent hardness? First is, permanent hardness can be removed. First method is washing soda method. This method is used for removal of permanent hardness. So you know that what is the formula of washing soda? Formula of washing soda is Na2CO3. Washing soda formula is Na2CO3. If we use this washing soda, we can remove the permanent hardness. So this washing soda reacts with this washing soda reacts with calcium, magnesium, chloride and sulfate to form insoluble product. One thing to see there, here for removing the hardness, we convert the soluble impurities into insoluble impurities. So for removing insoluble impurities converted into soluble impurities converted into insoluble. Soluble impurities is converted into insoluble impurities. So for this, in all the methods of removing permanent hardness, finally we convert soluble impurities into insoluble impurities. So what we discuss that in washing soda method, what we use? Washing soda react with calcium, magnesium sulfate and chloride to form insoluble, or we can say precipitate, insoluble salts. So we convert soluble salts into insoluble salt. So we write MCl2 plus Na2CO3, it react with, and it forms what it form? It form here insoluble. So what it will form? MCO3 plus MCO3 plus 2 NaCl. So this is soluble. This is insoluble. So instead of this, we can take calcium chloride plus Na2CO3, it forms calcium carbonate plus NaCl. So instead of this, we can take magnesium also. So this will be magnesium carbonate and 2 NaCl. So what we have discussed, calcium carbonate is formed, and that is insoluble impurities. That is another word we may say, that is, so main motto of removing permanent hardness is to convert soluble impurities into insoluble impurities by using some chemical. Second, here MSO4 means calcium or magnesium sulfate. React with washing soda. To form magnesium carbonate and sodium sulfate. Here, or we can write, instead of this, calcium, maybe, or magnesium. So what we have seen, we have converted the soluble impurities into insoluble impurities. Here, these are insoluble, and when we filter the water, so insoluble impurities remains on filter paper, and by that we separate the insoluble impurities from the water and finally water change into soft water. Means hard water change into soft water. So by this first method, hard water to soft water. And it can be used for various purposes. Second method to remove permanent hardness is collagen method. Second is collagens method. Okay. We use this method. And what causes permanent hardness? Permanent hardness causes if calcium and magnesium solvents are present in form of chloride and sulfate, they causes permanent hardness. So in collagen methods, collagen resin is used. What is collagen resin? Sodium hexametaphosphate. Collagen, what is collagen resin? Sodium hexametaphosphate. It known as collagen, known as collagen resin. Collagen sodium hexametaphosphate. When it dissolves, when it is added in hard water, it ionized like this. Na6, O18. When it ionizes, when it is added in water, it ionizes like this. How it ionized? Na4, P6, O18 double bond here, and 2 Na+. What we have seen here, when sodium hexametaphosphate is added in water, it ionizes like this, and it reacts with calcium or magnesium ions. This is anionic part, anionic, and by that we can say cationic part. So this anionic part reacts with calcium or magnesium ion. Calcium or magnesium ion to form a complex it forms complex like this, it forms Na2, 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 you have seen that it has formed complex. It has formed complex like this. Okay, and this complex remain in water. This complex remain in water. Well, we filter the water. This complex remain on filter paper, and it removes the permanent hardness of water. What we have discussed? We discussed that Carlson method. This one is known as Carlson resin. When we add it in water, following reaction takes place, are it ionized like this. Anionic part and cationic part. this anionic part, this anionic part react with calcium or magnesium ion that are present in hard water and that causes impurities. So it react with calcium or magnesium ion and form a complex, and this complex remain in a solution, or we can say in water. When we filter the water, these are remains on filter paper and hard water changes into soft water. So we discussed it. Two methods we have discussed. First method we discussed washing soda method, and second is Colgan's method. Two methods we discussed. So next method is ion exchange method, zeolite method or permutit method. Zeolite method or permutit method. So this method is also very important method for removal of permanent hardness. So we have three names for that: ion exchange method, zeolite method or permutit method. You remember it. So here term zeolite, the term zeolite, here sodium aluminium silicate, sodium aluminium silicate, that is sodium aluminium silicate. What is sodium aluminium silicate? This one is known as zeolite. What is this one is known as zeolite. When in salt form, zeolite can be represented as NaS. Means it can be written as NaS. Instead of this, we can write this way. Instead of Al, AlSiO4, we can write NaS. So it can be written NaS. We have NaS on zeolite method. We have NaS on zeolite method. So NaS here. When this zeolite is added, to hard water containing calcium and magnesium soluble impurities, it exchanges the iron and it forms the salt. It exchanges the iron and form the salt like this. It is solid form. It also solid form. And it forms compound like this. Insoluble impurities like this. When NaS react with calcium or magnesium ion, which are present in hard water, they form complex. What type? MZ2. Complex plus Na plus. Okay. So here MZ, we can balance it. MZ2 and 2 NaS. It is insoluble. So we saw insoluble impurities like this. As we can say precipitate also, because it is insoluble. When NaS is being added to hard water, the hard water reacts it and it forms complex. Means NaS forms complex with calcium or magnesium ion present in hard water and it forms the insoluble salt MZ2 and 2NaPlus. So when it filters, the water is filtered these insoluble impurities remain on filter paper, and hard water change into
soft water.
What? When NaS react with calcium or magnesium ion, it forms insoluble impurities and sodium ions. And when we filter water, the insoluble impurity remain on the filter paper and we get soft water. So by this process, we can also purify the hard water to soft water, or we can change the hard water to soft water. One point we will see here, NaSZ means that this is zeolite. When all the sodium ions of zeolite has been used, so we say zeolite is exhausted. Zeolite is exhausted. We pass this solution. This solution means MZ2 in brine solution. So brine solution. And it again forms NaZ plus MCl. NaZ and MCl. So by this we can regenerate the zeolite. And we get the brine. So it means when zeolite is passed through brine solution, it again form or it again regenerate. And when it said to be exhausted, when all the sodium ions of zeolite has been used, zeolite is said to be exhausted. So when exhausted, we can regain the zeolite. How we can regain the zeolite? By passing zeolite through brine solution, we get the regenerated zeolite. So three methods we discussed here. First is washing soda method. Second is Colgan method, and third is ion exchange method or zeolite or permutid method. The next and last method to remove permanent hardness is synthetic resin method. This is last method, means fourth method to remove permanent hardness of water. This method is used, and this method is more efficient than zeolite. Means nowadays this method is being used to remove permanent hardness, and this method is more efficient than zeolite method. So what have we seen in this method? This method is more efficient than the ion exchange method. Here, the formula of this resin is RSO3H. But we don't use in this form. It has large organic molecule and insoluble SO3H. So we convert or we change it in RNA plus by treating it with NaCl. When it is being treated, it changes into this. And in this form, it is being used. In this form, it is being used. So how it is being used? When it reacts or even it added to water, it reacts with ions, calcium or magnesium ion, and forms insoluble impurities. Insoluble impurities or insoluble salt. When we filter the water, we get the insoluble free salt water, means hard water to soft water. So cation exchange resin contain large organic molecule with SO3 group or water insoluble on treating with NaCl, RCO3 is changed into RNA plus. When this one react with water, means how it change? RSO3H plus NaCl, it react and it forms RNA plus, SO3 plus SC. The resin exchanges the Na ions with calcium and magnesium and present in hard water to make the soft water. Means this exchange the calcium and magnesium ions present in hard water to make soft. Means this exchange the calcium or magnesium ions present in hard water to make soft water. This also can be regained. When this is made to react with brine solution, means NaCl solution. If R or all Na is used, it should be said that it is exhausted. So it can be regained by reacting that with brine solution. This method is more efficient than the zeolite method. And we use this method, more economical method, and we use to purify the water or changing hard water to soft water. By this method, we get mineral-free water, pure demineralized water. So how we get pure demineralized water, we will discuss. By this method, we get pure demineralized water. First, the hard water is passed through the cation exchange resin and then anion exchange resin. So cation exchange resin may the excess of H plus ion in water, and anion exchange resin make the OH minus ion in water, and finally the H ions and OH ions react to each other and form water. So no ions are present in that water, and that's why we say pure demineralized water. So how will we get pure demineralized water? Let us discuss. So what we discuss here, by this method we get the pure demineralized water, means water free from all the ions. How is it possible? You may see, when hard water is passed through cation exchange resin, it exchanges the resin, it exchanges the cationic ions and make water acidic. When this again pass through anionic ion resin, anionic exchange resin is exchange ions and ions present in water and liberate OH, and finally the OH ion react with H plus ion and makes the water free from ions. By this method, means all the ions has been removed. So let us see. Cation exchange ion. Here, when it is used or when water containing calcium or magnesium ions is passed through or whatever cations have is passed through cation exchange resin, it forms the insoluble salt and release H plus ion, makes the water acidic. The H ions exchange for Na plus, Ca plus, Mg plus and other cationic ions present in water and makes water acidic. Because H plus is being released. When this water again pass through anionic exchange resin, RnS2 plus H2O, it forms RnS3OH minus. It exchange the anionic resin, anionic ions like Cl, SCO3, SO4, etc. Means other all the anionic ions. Here, OH minus exchanges the anions like Cl, SCO3, SO4, etc. present in water and OH liberated. Neutralize the H ions and makes the water free from ions. Means anionic resin exchanges all the anions from the water, whatever anions are there, and liberate OH minus. So H minus from cationic exchange resin and OH minus from anionic exchange resin, they react to each other and form water molecules. So what we have seen, all the ions are exchanged by hydrogen ion and all the anions are exchanged by OH ion. So only H ion and OH ion were present in the water, and finally they react. Finally they reacted and they form H2O. So water becomes free from all the anions, and we get the water or demineralized water by this method. And when cationic and anionic resin are exhausted, so when cationic resin are passed through HCl, they can be regenerated. And means when cationic resin are exhausted, means you know that part does mean have exhausted if all the ions have been used. So they are being passed through dilute acid to regenerate, and anionic exchange resin are passed through, are made to react with alkalis, diluted alkalis to regenerate. So we can regenerate also. Listen this, when cationic and anionic resins are exhausted, we can regenerate. How we can regenerate? When cationic exchange resin is passed through diluted acid, that can be regenerated. When anionic resin are passed through the diluted alkalis, they can be also regenerated. So we have discussed this method, and this method is more efficient. So what methods, how many methods we have discussed? We discussed 4 methods to remove permanent hardness. So what are the 4 methods? Just we can summarize it. What are the 4 methods? So first method was, what was the washing soda method? What? Washing soda method. Second was Calgon's method. Third was ion exchange method. And fourth is synthetic resin method. Synthetic resin method. So we can summarize it. We use Na2CO3. And by this process we have converted the soluble impurities into insoluble impurities. Colgan method, we have used Colgan resin, and this method is very important. Colgan method, and resin is used Na6P6O18, sodium hexametaphosphate, sodium hexametaphosphate. And next is ion exchange method. What we have used here? It is known as zeolite method. Zeolite method or permutit method. And zeolite, sodium aluminium silicate. And inside we wrote is NaCl. So we have NaCl on ion exchange method. And here we have used 2 resins, cation exchange resin that is made to react. Cation exchange resin that is made to react means what we have used RSO3S, and we made to react with NaCl, and we change it RNA+. It is used. And when we passed hard water to cation exchange resin, and then means when we pass hard water, cation acidic water, and when it passed through, due to presence of H+, passed through anion exchange resin, it exchange means OH ion exchange the anionic resin, anionic ions, and it change into basin due to presence of OH. And finally H+ and OH ion react and they form H2O, and thus this water becomes free from all the ions present in hard water. So we say pure demineralized method. So we can ask which method is used to get pure demineralized method, so your answer will be synthetic resin method. So we have discussed. If you understood this, if you understand my videos, please share and like it.